Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Dr. Jyotsna Patel, practicing gynecologist and obstetrician at Krupa Hospital, 7 Bungalows, Mumbai, and at Umang Nursing Home, Andheri East, Mumbai. I've been practicing obstetrics and gynecology for last 20 years. Today's topic that I have decided to talk on is termination of pregnancy. Now, why did I choose this topic? Because in my practice, I have found that a lot of young girls who are sexually active from the age of 20 to 30 years, married and unmarried, are seeking the information about this termination. And I want this information to be given to them from the right source. We as gynecologists always promote safe abortions. Termination of pregnancy is when a woman does not desire to continue the pregnancy. Now, the reasons for not continuing the pregnancy could be anything. Either it could be a contraceptive failure, or it could be an unplanned pregnancy, or there could be a congenital defect in the baby, or there could be medical reasons for what the woman does not wish to continue the pregnancy. Now, termination of pregnancy can be divided into two groups: a first trimester pregnancy and a second trimester pregnancy. The legal limit of abortion is 20 weeks. Beyond 20 weeks, we cannot abort the pregnancy. The first trimester of pregnancy is from up to 12 weeks. Only up to 12 weeks is considered first trimester of pregnancy, which is done in most of the private hospitals. In this also, we have two methods. One is a medical method of abortion, and second is a surgical method of abortion. Now, when we say medical method of abortion, it has a limit. We terminate the pregnancies which are only up to 6 weeks. So only up to 6 weeks can you go for medical method of abortion. This involves taking tablets. Now, the tablets that are given is one tablet is given on day one, and four tablets are given on day two. The day two tablets can be given orally, or they can be taken even vaginally. The medical method of abortion has its advantages and disadvantages. The most important advantage is it's a non-invasive procedure. That means we are not touching any of the internal organs. So it's more suitable for girls who are sexually active and who are not married and who are only up to 6 weeks. They can safely go ahead with this method of abortion. But of course, it needs to be taken from the right source. So you need to go to only a gynecologist when you do not wish to continue a pregnancy. Please do not go to any other doctor, any general practitioner, or any other alternative medicine doctors. Because as I said, we want to promote safe abortions. So the advantages, as I said, is it's a non-invasive procedure. It's an OPD procedure. That means you take the tablet and you go home. You need not get admitted. There is no anesthesia involved. So again, the risk of anesthesia is not there, and there is no admission involved. So these are the advantages of medical method. Now, there are also some disadvantages. The disadvantages are that you need to bear the pain that comes with the consumption of tablets. So it's only when your uterus contracts, the products are expelled out. So you will get pain in this procedure. You will experience bleeding. It's very individualistic as to how much bleeding will be there and how much pain will be there, because everybody has a different threshold for pain, and everybody has a different capacity, or everybody's body is different as to how it bleeds, right? So the bleeding can last for say 3 to 4 days to a week. So as I said, there is going to be pain, there's going to be bleeding. And again, we need to reconfirm whether the procedure is complete once the bleeding stops. So that may take, like, you may have to go to your gynecologist after 10 days again to confirm whether everything is clear. So this is medical method of abortion. Again, only up to 6 weeks, only to be given by gynecologists. And you need to make sure that everything is clear by revisiting your gynecologist. Now, again, beyond 6 weeks, or even up to 6 weeks also, you have, if you do not wish to go for medical method, you can go for surgical termination. Now, surgical termination can be done up to 12 weeks, that is first trimester. And as I said, most of the private nursing homes are doing this procedure routinely. Now, the advantages of this procedure is that it is in one day you're free of the pregnancy. Okay, so it requires admission for one day, it requires anesthesia, and it is done in a day. So you don't have to wait for a week or 10 days to, you know, confirm that your pregnancy is clear or not clear. So that is the advantage. The disadvantage is that since it's a surgical procedure, again, it requires admission. It requires anesthesia. So there comes the risk of anesthesia. And since it's a surgical procedure, it's an invasive procedure. That means we are touching inside. Through your vagina, we are going inside, we are doing suction evacuation, and the products are taken out by our instruments. So again, aseptic precautions need to be taken. So as I said, again, to be done only by gynecologists. So surgical method has its advantages and disadvantages. Now comes beyond 12 weeks. Now beyond 12 weeks, most of the private setups are not doing it. Okay, and even the government is very you know vigilant about giving the permission to nursing homes about doing it beyond 12 weeks. So you'll find that most of the government hospitals and municipal hospitals are doing beyond 12 weeks. That is why it's very important to decide whether you wish to continue or do not wish to continue as early as possible. Do not wait for so long that it becomes difficult for you to then do it in a private setup, and then you are only left to go to government hospitals. Because beyond 12 weeks, as I said, you need to preferably go to municipal or government setups, as not many private hospitals have permission to do it. In the second trimester, the reasons are usually the medical reasons. Suppose if the mother is suffering from some medical disorder, which as her pregnancy will grow, will affect her health. So in that cases, it is done. And again, if the baby is having some congenital anomaly, which is detected only after 3 months, okay? So in those cases, they need to go for the second trimester abortion. Again, the limit is only up to 20 weeks. Okay, so it's very important that you follow the instructions given by your gynecologist and obstetrician to do the sonographies at 12 weeks, again at 16 weeks, again at 18 weeks to confirm that your pregnancy is absolutely normal and you're not missing out on any congenital anomaly. Because then again, beyond 20 weeks, it is very sad that the woman needs to continue the pregnancy with that abnormal child in her womb, which as an obstetrician, it's a big dilemma for us. And there have been cases where women have gone to court and taken permission to abort their pregnancies. But again, it's a lengthy procedure and there's a lot of, you know, mental stress that comes along with it. So this is what today I wanted you to have the information about termination of pregnancy. So recapping it, you have first trimester and second trimester. First trimester involves medical method and surgical method. Medical method to be done only up to 6 weeks. Surgical method can be done up to 12 weeks. Each procedure has its advantages and disadvantages. Beyond 12 weeks is second trimester, which has specific indications. I hope the information that I have given you is useful to you. And if you need any more queries, you can contact me on Lybrate.com. Thank you.